everyone, welcome to Spiritual Butterfly. Today I will be doing a love reading for Gemini. So we are going to be looking at your current love situation. This is going to be a pick a card style reading. I have two hearts here, and this is heart A and heart B. So you can ground your energy, you know, use your intuition to pick which heart resonates with you or is speaking to you, I should say. So remember that these messages are general. They will not resonate with everyone. Take what does, Gemini, apply it and leave the rest. Also, Gems, remember to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and click that notification bell in order to receive notifications when I post. So I'm going to give you a few moments and then we're going to get right into the messages. Okay, Gems, let's get started. This is pile A. Let's see what message spirit has for you. It says a message for you. I'm thinking of you this very moment. Your love fills me with light. I love you. Okay. I heard you're always on my mind. So yes, I heard constantly by immature. Yes. There is someone who is constantly thinking about you. You are on their mind. Yeah, I heard like 7 days a week. I heard 24/7. Yes, Gemini. Someone is definitely thinking about you. Of course, the roles could be reversed, Gemini. This could be you constantly thinking about someone. But yes, someone is definitely either on your mind or you're on someone's mind. So let's pull some more messages to go a little bit deeper. Spirit, tell me more about this message for you. For some of you, I feel like this person is someone from your past. Spirit, give me some messages for group A. Come on, Gemini, despair. Yeah, this is someone from your past. This is someone you walked away from. This person doesn't know what to do. This person does not know what to do to get you back. I heard I've tried everything. So this person has tried everything, but nothing is working. I heard move on. Yes, I feel like for some of you, you have moved on. A song just came to me. I can't leave you alone. Like this person, they just can't get over you. They want that good thing back, Gemini. Yes. I heard like out of luck. I feel like this person has missed their chance. They have missed their opportunity with you. So let's get some more messages to go a little bit deeper. Spirit, tell me more about despair. Look at what I have. Make the effort. Great love is worth taking the steps you're guided to take. This person is coming back. I heard attempt, to make another attempt. Yes. I heard I won't stop at nothing. Yeah, this person won't stop at anything. Like, they are serious about getting you back. I heard the love of my life. This person feels like you're the love of their life. For some of you, I heard teenage love. You may have dated this person when you were younger. Or may have started dating when you were younger, and there's a very significant history between the both of you, and they cannot get over you. Like, this person just cannot move on. Let's pull some more messages. Spirit, tell me more about make the effort. I have self-love in the reverse. For some of you, you overgave when it came to this relationship. Like, I heard your own wants. You sacrificed your own needs and your own wants for this connection. And I feel like once you left this person, once you walked away, you were able to just focus on yourself, do what makes you happy. Let's get a message for self-love. Yep, I have marriage in the reverse. Yeah, you gave. You feel like you sacrificed a lot to be with this person. You gave up a lot for this person, for this marriage, and it's like it didn't work out. So you chose to walk away. You finally chose to disconnect. And ever since you've been gone, this person's life has not been the same. I heard losses. So this person has taken loss after loss after loss. Since you walked away, their life has did a complete turn. Things have definitely changed for this person. I heard like karma. For some of you, this is their karma. I heard like bad luck and bad energy. Yeah. For how they treated you. Like this person is experiencing a lot of turmoil. And I heard it was you. This person recognizes just how valuable you were to their life. I heard like a good luck charm. But at the time, they weren't willing to give. They weren't willing to invest. You were the one doing all of the giving. I heard settle. For some of you, like you settled for this relationship because you didn't know your worth. You didn't value yourself at this time. But it's like now that you are older, now that you know better, you are deciding to do better. So let's pull some advice for you, Group A. Spirit, what advice do you have for Group A? Advice for Group A. Spirit says you did the right thing. You did the right thing by walking away from this person. I have the Seven of Wands. Let's get some more messages. This person is going to try to catch you off guard. This person is going to try to catch you off guard. I have the Fool. And let's get one more message. Yeah, I heard when you least expect it. For some of you, this person is going to come back when you least expect it. But I heard I'm ready. You're going to be ready for it, Group A. Let's get one more message. Yep, I have justice. I heard the scales have been balanced. The scales have been balanced. I heard the grass was not greener. I feel like with the Fool, this is your person. This is the person you were connected to. They made a lot of poor decisions in their life. Always searching for the next best thing. And always ending up regretting it. It's like a continual cycle with this person. They're always looking for something new. Like they're never satisfied. They're always looking for fulfillment outside of themselves. And it's like they don't recognize that they have to first find happiness within. And it's like with this Fool, this person is coming back thinking that they can weasel their way back in. But it's like, no, you've changed. You've grown. They still think you're the same person that they left. Or the same person you were before you walked away. And that's not the truth. You've grown. I heard like on the defense. Yeah, you're ready to defend yourself. You're no longer allowing this person into your life. And I just get like a very immature energy. This person is very immature. And I just get her karma. Like they're really going through a lot of despair. Like they're experiencing a lot of setbacks, a lot of tribulations. Spirit is saying the scales have been balanced. So where you're living your best life, you're free, you're happy, this person isn't. They're wishing, they're hoping to have you back in their life. I heard the past returns. Like this person wants to relive the past. They're stuck. They're stuck in a cycle. That's their karma. They're stuck in a never-ending cycle of trying to relive the past. Never being able to move forward in life. They just keep repeating the same thing over and over. That's their karma, justice. I'm gonna pull one more message. Spirit, tell me more about this justice. Yep, I have the magician in the reverse. They're not going to be able to manifest like this person. They're going to be stuck. They're not going to be able to have what they want in life. They're not going to be able to attract what they want, what they desire. They're going to be stuck. Stuck in despair, stuck being unhappy. Spirit, give me a message for the Fool. I have the Hangman in the reverse. This person makes very poor decisions. They don't think things through. They just jump. They just move. I heard action. They don't think things through. Spirit, tell me about the Seven of Wands. I have the Star. But they see you over here shining. You've grown. You have really leveled up since you left this person. You have leveled up. I heard like things working out in your favor. Like your life has completely transformed. You have transformed, Gemini. So there's no need for you to go back to the past. Spirit says keep your guards up. And use this experience to help you when it comes to future relationships. And then look at what else I have. The Queen of Pentacles, you have leveled up. Yes. There's a lot of growth. Materially, physically, mentally. I heard dieting for some of you. You've changed your appearance, the way you look. You may have lost weight. I heard hair. You may have changed the way you style your hair, the way that you dress. Your money is looking good. You're finally able to do for yourself the way that you want to. Have the things that you desire in life. Yeah. Because you're no longer attached to someone who has negative energy. Because when you're in a relationship with someone who isn't operating at a high vibration, that energy impacts your life. So you have to be careful of who you allow into your space. Because you don't want anyone to sabotage what you have going for yourself. So group A, these are your messages. I hope they resonate. Stay true to thyself and real with thyself. Grow with me as I grow with you. Everyone, stay blessed. Hello, Group B. So, if you chose Group B, you chose this heart. And we are going to see what's going on in your love life. So, let's turn it over and see what message Spirit has. It says, time. You are trying too hard. Give it time. So, yes. I heard, don't rush. That's the first message. Spirit says, do not rush. Take your time. Get to know this person. I heard something's hidden. For some of you, this person isn't being completely honest. Like they're not telling you the truth when it comes to a situation. I heard like child's mom. For someone, they're not telling you the truth when it comes to the mother of their child. I heard like they're still dealing with each other. And I heard separated. So this person may have told you that, you know, they're no longer in any type of relationship with the mother of their child. It's only about the child or the children and that's it. But this person isn't being honest. They're still seeing each other. I heard like hanky panky. So they're still being intimate. Yeah, someone, I heard like disclosure. Yeah, someone's not being honest. So let's pull some messages to go a little bit deeper. Spirit, tell me more about Group B's love life. Messages for Group B. I have privileged lady. This is you, Group B. Whether you're a male or a female, this is you, privileged lady. When people look at you, they see you as someone who has everything together, who has everything that they need. For some people, they may be intimidated by you, intimidated by your success, intimidated just by the energy that you give off, by your appearance. Like you just appear to just have everything together. You appear to be someone of just high value, high quality. I heard the right one will do. For some of you, Spirit is saying, wait for the right person. Don't be in such a rush to get into a relationship. Like, take your time. For someone like you're dating, and Spirit is saying, like, just take your time. Don't rush into it. Get to know this person. I heard intentions, because they may not have good intentions. So let's pull some more messages to go a little bit deeper. Spirit, tell me more about this privileged lady. I have engagement. Your love life is ascending to a higher level of commitment. For some of you, I'm getting that this person only wants to marry you or only wants to be in a relationship with you because of your status. I heard background. You may come from a very good family. Yeah, this person, I heard like meal ticket. They only want to be with you for the lifestyle. This person doesn't genuinely care about you, Gemini. So be very careful. This person just wants to use you for your status and your money. And they are trying to rush you into a relationship, rush you into marriage, pretty much just rush you down the aisle. Yeah. I'm also getting forceful for some of you. This person may be trying to force you to marry them. I heard impregnate. For some of you, this person is going to try to get pregnant or get pregnant by you in order to secure the bag, in order to secure the ring. Let's pull some more messages. Spirit, tell me more about engagement. I have lessons in fear. Yeah. For some of you, I heard like fear of being alone. You may be afraid that like you're never going to meet the right person. Like you're going to be alone forever. You may have been single for a very long time. And it's like you just have a fear of being alone. I feel like with these lessons, Spirit says practice what you preach. Practice what you preach. If you say that you believe in something or you're saying that you're about something, practice that. Like just. Spirit, give me a message for lessons. have passion in the reverse. For some of you, don't become intimate too quickly and don't fall too quickly for this person. I heard like guard up, you know, still be guarded. Make this person earn a spot in your life. Don't just give it freely. Make them earn it. So I'm getting, don't be intimate too quickly and don't fall too quickly for this person. Take your time, because not all is what it seems. Let's get a message for passion. I have dreams. I heard they fantasize about you. For someone, there's someone who's fantasizing about you. Fantasizing what it would be like to be with you when it comes to intimacy. For others of you, I'm getting, you may have been celibate for a while. You may have been celibate for a very long time, and I feel like you're waiting for the right person. For someone, I heard like virgin, you may actually be a virgin, and you're waiting for the right person to come along. I heard commitment, yeah, you're waiting for a commitment. For some of you, like you're waiting for marriage. Let's get a message for fear. You may mentor women or young girls. That's what I'm getting for someone. Practice what you preach. Yeah, live the life that you speak unto others. That same advice that you give, live by that. Spirit, tell me about fear. I strongly feel like someone mentors young women or young girls, and it's like you're in a situation where you just met someone. I heard force, this person may be trying to force you when it comes to being intimate, force you when it comes to this connection, moving too quickly, not wanting to really take their time. And I heard like at a loss, you feel like if you don't give in, this person is going to walk away. And you have a fear of rejection, a fear of being alone. So there's a part of you that wants to give in to this person's demands. But you give messages about self-worth and self-love and about not settling. But you're thinking about settling. You're thinking about putting someone else's needs, desires before your own. So practice what you preach. Like, take heed to your own advice. I have betrayal in the reverse. For some of you, you have a fear of being hurt again. There's a fear of being hurt again. Spirit, tell me more about betrayal. I have temptation. Yeah, someone is definitely thinking about being intimate. I heard like hot and heavy, yes. Someone is definitely thinking about being intimate, but there's someone in this connection that's holding back out of fear. Fear of being hurt. Fear of being betrayed. I feel like with dreams, this person checks all of the boxes, but I heard like too good to be true. You feel like it's too good to be true, Gemini. And I heard like harm's way, like you don't want to put yourself in a situation where, you know, you're going to be hurt. So you're holding back. I heard making them work for it for someone. This is about you knowing your value. So whether you're thinking about giving in to this person or not, this is just about you knowing your value, knowing what you have to offer. Knowing that you have more to offer than just physical intimacy. There's more to you. And it's like you want this person to value all parts of you, not just the physical. Yeah, her love yourself. For some of you, you've been like on a healing journey, like a self-love journey. And you've made it to this place where you're finally at peace. You're comfortable in your own skin. And it's like you don't want to regress. Like you don't want to repeat the cycle. You don't want to have to start all over again. So it's like you're holding on to the growth. You're holding on to your transformation. I heard like, look at how far you've come. Yeah, you've come very far. You've changed. You've evolved and you don't want to go backwards. For some of you, you may have had a history of being very promiscuous. And I heard like change your ways, like you've just changed, you've outgrown that behavior. And it's like now you understand more about physical intimacy, like there's just so much more to it, you know, soul ties come with it. And you want to make sure that you're giving yourself away to the right person. Privileged lady is not just about how other people see you, Gemini. It's about how you see yourself. And for a lot of you, I feel like you're seeing yourself as privileged, as like, you know, worthy. Like you know that you're worthy. So let's pull some overall advice. Spirit, give me some advice for Group B. I have the Seven of Swords. Let's get some more advice. I have the Knight of Swords, and I have the Hermit. Yeah, I heard like turn off. I feel like for some of you, the fact that this person is trying to move too quickly when it comes to this relationship, you feel like they're hiding something. So this is turning you off, and this is just going to cause you to retreat. And it's like with this Hermit, like you're older now, you're wiser, you know better. So it's like I heard red flags, like you're really paying attention to the red flags. And for some of you, you're going to be choosing just to retreat, to walk away, not to entertain this person. I feel like for some of you, this person is just very immature. They're very immature. And I heard lack confidence. They may have issues when it comes to being confident. Like they mask their insecurities. But it's like you don't have time for that. Like you're just on a different level mentally, emotionally, spiritually. Like, you're evolved and this person is unevolved. Let's get a message for the Hermit. I have death in the reverse. I heard you don't want to repeat a cycle. I heard you don't want to repeat any cycles. You've learned from the past, and it's like you're not willing to repeat a cycle. For some of you, this is someone from your past who's coming back in, but it's like you have matured so much, you've grown so much, that you really don't want to repeat any cycles. I'm also getting rebirth with this card for some of you. Yeah, you've been through a transformation, a rebirth. Spirit, tell me more about death in the reverse. Yep, I have the Five of Swords in reverse. So it's like you know what to give to and what not to give to. Like, you know what to fight for and what not to fight for. Like, you know better now. Your spirit says you know better. For some of you, spirit says test. Like, this is a test. This is a test to see if you have really learned. If you are going to repeat the cycle. And for a lot of you, the answer is no. You're not giving to this. You're not fighting for this. You're backing away from it. You have learned. You know better. Therefore, you are doing better. So, Group B, these are your messages. I hope they resonate. Stay true to thyself and real with thyself. Grow with me as I grow with you. Everyone, stay blessed.